Dr. Chinmay Pandya's birth and upbringing in a spiritual academy in Shantikunj, Haridwar, ensured that he is deeply influenced by the Indian culture and tradition. Presently working as the Pro Vice Chancellor of the Dev Sanskriti University in Haridwar, his spiritual and managerial capabilities are helping the university go leaps and bounds and becoming a model institution on its very domain. A man of many talents, he is also working as an editor of International Journal on Vedic Culture, popularly known as Dev Shakti. Apart from that, he chairs the International Festival of Yoga, Culture and Spirituality. Friends, he travels 6 hours from Haridwar to be here with us and will be doing the same after the session. Sir, we are really grateful to you to have spared a lot of time for us. So let us all please welcome Dr. Chinmay Pandya to deliver his talk on human excellence to guide us all through the path of excellence and sacred life.
Good evening to everyone. First of all, I just wanted to say thank you and my utmost gratitude to Sahil and all the team members here for so kindly embracing us from Shantikunj, Haridwar here. And before I start, I just wanted to tell everyone that, you know, it's an unfortunate thing that about 100 years or so ago, when Swami Vivekananda, he represented India in US, these clothes used to mean something else. But immediately, the moment actually you see someone in these clothes, there is immediate disconnect and skepticism in your mind. So I just wanted to ease your minds that I am not going to preach anything here. I am not here to stand and talk about anything that would not stuck to your mind. But I really want to talk about things that actually the leaders of tomorrow should embrace. And because, you know, it's a privilege. It's really a privilege to talk with those people who are the future of this nation. Aap log aise log hain jo jinme se bahut sare log kal ke din policy bana rahe honge is desh ki, and you would be the policy makers of this nation. It's really a privilege to talk with you guys, because leadership is not about being captain of a team. It's about, you know, having this belief that we all have got a capability, we all have got a potential to change this world, and I'm going to talk about that issue. This presentation that you would see here is the human excellence, and there is a small history behind it. When 4 months ago Sahil contacted me and he asked me to speak about the ethics in the public life. And that time I was in Jordan, just about to actually leave for Jordan. In Jordan we had a small congregation, you know, arranged by the United Nations, and they selected 24 scholars from all over the world, and I was one of them, to draft a resolution for the United Nations. And one of my good friends, Jerry White, he is the Nobel Peace Prize winner and Nobel laureate and also Deputy Secretary of State for United States. And he presented there actually the public life ethics, and he was talking about Sir Christopher Nolan's principle, selflessness, integrity, openness and all these things. And soon after that I had the presentation on human excellence. So he said, actually we both are talking about the same thing. You are talking about the same thing, about the principles of the public ethics, and you should talk about the about this thing. So that night when we were having the discussion close to the Dead Sea, we thought that maybe the human excellence would be the right thing. So I mentioned it to Sahil that maybe I should talk about the human excellence to you guys rather than talking about the ethics in the public life. So I would ask you that, you know, listen to this presentation with an open mind. Listen to this presentation because it is more than a presentation. It's a, the idea of this presentation is not to offer you any answer. Idea of this presentation is to offer you the questions that I would really like you guys to move out of this room and think about your life, think about what is happening around you, think about what is happening in this country and nation and the society around you, and think about it with a different eye. Think about it with a questionable eye. Think about whether we can do something different to make this world a better place. And that is the idea of this presentation, human excellence. And there is also a small story that about a year ago when Indian Military Academy invited us to do a presentation on human excellence, because if you ever go to Indian Military Academy, it's written in the board that, you know, we develop excellence in our shoulders. So before we went, actually, of course, the Indian Military Academy is the prestigious institution of India. Their idea was that they wanted to be sure before we would do any presentation that we would not talk about any aspect which is religious or any such thing. So we had a pre you know, presentation talk with the Major General of the Indian Military Academy. And when we talked about, it became clear to us that the excellence the way army thinks about the excellence in their soldiers or the way we think about the excellence in human being are two different things. So that is also history behind it, that you know the idea that what that every human being coming to this world with endless possibilities. We have come to this planet with millions of possibilities, and the pinnacle of our possibility is the excellence. That is the idea, that if we all develop, nurture and reach to the you know summit of our life, jis kaam ko karne ke liye hum log paida hue the, if we all are able to do that, then we have got the excellence in the life. That is the idea. So I would like to start this presentation, and this presentation is very simple. It has got only few slides, but mostly to think about the things that are of different nature to us. Teen chote chote stages is presentation ke andar aayenge. First is that you know this life, human life, Gurudev used to say that either we have got this by default, ya to hum logon ko by mistake mil gayi hai life, hum logon ko by mistake birth mil gayi hai, and if we have got this life by default, then we should do everything to waste this one, or we have got this life as a blessing. And if we have got this life as a blessing, then it is our moral responsibility to think about what can we do different with this human life. So the idea is that if we can do something different with the human life, then this is the excellence. So the presentation has got two aspects. One is to start from the point of view that how enlightened souls, how illuminated beings, how those people who live their lives to perfection, what they think about the human life. And second aspect is to think whether we are doing justice to that kind of life. And if we are not, then what can we do different to live a better life than what has been given to us. And I'm going to start with Swami Vivekananda. Everyone knows that the person who lived only up to the age of 32-39 and you know shook the Western world with his philosophy. He said many beautiful things. Is it possible to have the light dim over here? I think, is it possible for everyone to read at the back? Thoda isko dim kar sakte hain. You able to see it at the back? Huh? Alright, so I'm going to start with the quotation of Swami Vivekananda, that all the power, he said, all the power in the universe is already ours. It is we who have put our hands before our eyes and cry that it is there. Harek ko Bhagwan ne, if there is a divinity, it works only on one policy, and that is the equal opportunity policy, that we all actually come to this planet with same sort of possibilities. What was given to one person had the same possibility for another person to grow. And it is up to us that how much actually we take the gauntlet and try to actually change our life. And this is the same idea, ki wahi suraj hai, har ek ke upar ugra hai, yadi hum log khidki band kar lein, darwaje band kar lein, apna chehra ghuma karke khade ho jaye, and then we complain ki aaj ke din suraj nahi nikla, so it's not a fault of the suraj, it's not a fault of the sun. That we were given the opportunity, and that's what he meant to say, that you know, har ek ke andar, everyone has been given the same power, but if we close our eyes, if we cry, and then we cry that it is dark, then it is not a fault of anyone else. And when Swami Vivekananda used to say this statement, he also used to share a story. And he used to share a story of a lioness. He ate a lioness and she was pregnant. And she was walking in the forest and there was a hunter that came. Hunter ne peeche se shoot kiya, to lioness jo hai, she died. And when she died, she gave birth to a lion. Aur jo lion tha, you know, it was looked after by the herd of deers. So soon after, you know, because उसको हिरण पाल रहे थे, ही फॉरगॉट कि ही वॉज अ लायन, ही स्टार्टेड टू थिंक दैट ही वॉज अ डियर. और उसके बाद क्या हुआ कि वन डे ए एडल्ट लायन केम. मोमेंट एडल्ट लायन केम, एडल्ट लायन रोर. जैसे ही एडल्ट लायन ने रोर किया, ऑल द डियर्स स्टार्टेड टू रन एंड दिस लायन ऑल्सो स्टार्टेड टू रन. सो लायन थॉट, यू नो, डियर्स आर रनिंग, दैट इज फाइन, व्हाई द हेल दिस डियर इज रनिंग. सो ही फॉरगॉट अबाउट द लायंस एंड ही स्टार्टेड टू थिंक अबाउट दिस लायन. उसने उसको पकड़ा, उसने कहा भाई आप कहाँ भाग रहे हो भाई. तो उसने कहा, लायन ने कहा कि अरे मैं, आई एम नॉट लायन, आई एम डियर. उसने कहा नो यू आर ए लायन. उसने कहा नो आई एम डियर. उसने उसको पकड़ा और वो उसको नदी के किनारे ले गया. एंड ही शोड हिम द फेस, एंड मोमेंट ही शोड हिम द फेस एंड ही सॉ दैट आई एम द सेम लायन एज द लायन नेक्स्ट टू मी, द लायन फ्रॉम इनसाइड इट रोल्ड बैक. उसके अंदर की जो दहाड़ थी वो वापस निकल करके आई. And I think that is the purpose also of the enlightened beings, whether it's the Swami Vivekananda or Maharshi Arvind or Gurudev or Ramana Maharshi, all the enlightened souls who come to this planet of course there is a divine agenda offered to them to accomplish on this planet, but there are another idea is to show us that if they can live their life to that potential, then we also have got the opportunity. You know, there is also a Gandhi sitting here, right in front of you. There is also a Subhash sitting right in front of you. If we all can listen to the potential that we have, then we all can live a life absolutely with a different meaning and a different goal. So the life actually is the range of possibilities. That, you know, as a human being, this is the beauty that's been offered to us, that we have got all sorts of possibilities. यदि रावण हमारे अंदर से निकल करके आता है तो राम भी हमारे अंदर से निकल करके आते हैं. यदि कंस इंसान के बीच में से निकल करके आता है तो कृष्ण भी निकल करके आते हैं. वी हैव गॉट द बोथ पॉसिबिलिटीज. इट डिपेंड्स दैट विच वन वी नर्चर. जिस पॉसिबिलिटी को हम लोग ग्रो कराना चाहते हैं, जिस पॉसिबिलिटी को हम लोग रियलिटी में बदलना चाहते हैं, दैट एक्चुअली टर्न्स इनटू द रियलिटी. देयर इज अ फेमस जैन स्टोरी कि वन जैन मास्टर वॉज डाइंग. He was about to die and he called his closest disciple. उसने उसको बुलाया, उसने कहा कि I will tell you the summary of my life. जो मेरे जीवन का सबसे important message था, I'm about to give to you. उसने कहा ठीक है. So he came, he said, there are two dogs living inside me. Like Jain stories go, कबीर की तरह से उनकी उलट बासियों की तरह कहानियाँ होती हैं. तो उसके शिष्य ने सोचा कि must be something strange he is going to say. उसने कहा there are two dogs living inside me. उसने कहा one wants the world, another wants the spirituality. एक को तो दुनिया चाहिए और एक को भगवान चाहिए. They are constantly fighting with each other. They are constantly fighting with each other. And now disciple was looking at the guru, what he is going to say. And he said, that dog wins. वो वाला कुत्ता जीतता है to whom you feed. जिसको कि आप खाना खिलाते हो. So we have got all sorts of possibilities. Whatever this possibility we would like to grow, जिसको भी हम लोग feed करेंगे, that possibility would turn into the reality of the life. And that is the purpose of the life. That, you know, if you look at the life, it is a journey from B to D. B to D is birth to death. कि जन्म से शुरू हुई है और मृत्यु पे खत्म हो जाएगी. Neither birth is in our hand nor death is in our hand. ना तो हम लोग ये तय कर सकते हैं कि हम लोग कब जन्म लेंगे, ना हम ये तय कर सकते हैं कि हम लोगों की मृत्यु कब होगी. So we can do with whatever left in the middle. Whatever left in the middle is the seed, choice. Ki the choice hai, iska matlab life hai. Ki we have got the choice to live in the manner we would like to live. Ki hum log jis bhi tarike se chahe apne jeevan ko jeene ke liye swatantr hain, we have got full possibility to live a life. And that is the idea of the excellence. Ki jab you know, Maharshi Arvind ne is baat ko kaha, actually it was one of his last statements, कि एवरी वन हैज़ इन हिम समथिंग डिवाइन, समथिंग इज ओन, ए चांस ऑफ परफेक्शन, ए स्ट्रेंथ इन हाउ एवर स्मॉल स्पीयर विच गॉड ऑफर्स हिम टू टेक और रिफ्यूज. द टास्क इज टू फाइंड इट, डेवलप इट एंड यूज इट. दिस इज वॉट वी कैन कॉल एक्सीलेंस. कि हम में से हर एक के अंदर कहीं ना कहीं किसी न किसी मात्रा में एक डिवाइन पोटेंशियल मौजूद है. हम में से हर एक के अंदर एक ये संभावना मौजूद है कि यदि हम लोग चाहें तो अपने जीवन को अच्छे तरीके से जी सकते हैं. एंड दैट इज वॉट एक्चुअली आई वुड लाइक यू टू रिमेंबर, कि हम में से हर कोई एक अच्छी पॉसिबिलिटी को लेकर के इस धरती पर आया है. और हम में से हर कोई यदि चाहे तो एक सेकंड को मैं यही आपसे कहना चाहता हूँ कि जब आप लोग इस जगह से निकलें तो आंसर्स को लेकर के नहीं निकलें. आंसर्स मेरे पास है भी नहीं, पर मैं आप लोगों को क्वेश्चंस देना चाहता हूँ. मैं चाहता हूँ कि हम में से हर कोई कम से कम इतना सेल्फ इंट्रोस्पेक्शन तो कर ही सकता है, इतनी सेल्फ एनालिसिस तो कर ही सकता है कि वेदर वी आर डूइंग जस्टिस टू द लाइफ दैट्स बीन गिवन टू अस. एंड इफ नॉट, then what can we do different to make it a meaningful thing? कि जब हम लोग जिंदगी का हमारा अंतिम चैप्टर लिखा जा रहा हो, and if our life is turned into a book and we have got 90 chapters written on this book, then every single leaf if we go through it and we would feel proud. कि हमें ऐसा लगे कि इसमें से कोई सा भी एक अक्षर ऐसा नहीं है जिसको कि मैं अपने जीवन में से बदलना चाहूँगा. Not even a single statement should be there that we should feel guilty about. हम लोगों को लगे कि हमने जिंदगी जितनी खूबसूरती के साथ जीनी चाहिए थी उतनी हमने जी. That is the whole idea of the excellence. The whole idea of excellence is that every single moment we have got the opportunity to think about life differently and to turn it differently. आप लोगों को पता नहीं पता है कि नहीं पता, पर when Edmund Hillary, he failed 15 times before reaching to the summit of Mount Everest. And just before, any of you ever been to Mount Everest, you know the base camp is at the altitude of 6,888 meter, and you are supposed to stay there for 3 months. और उसमें आपको तीन बार बिना ऑक्सीजन के जाना पड़ता है second base camp tak. But you are wahan tak teen baar chale jate hain, then they allow you to go. And you are only allowed to travel in the middle of the night, kyunki morning 2 o'clock ke baad se avalanche ke chances bad jate hain. So that was the last night, and after that there was no chance that Edmund Hillary would scale the Mount Everest in that year. So before going, he looked at the Mount Everest and he said, you are a mountain, you are a rock, you cannot grow anymore. But as a human being, I can. कि मेरे अंदर ये possibility है, आप तो पहाड़ हो, ज़्यादा से ज़्यादा 6 मीटर बढ़ोगे, 8 मीटर बढ़ोगे, पर मैं human being हूँ and I can grow. And this possibility that we all can grow, कि हम में से हर कोई आगे बढ़ सकता है, हम में से हर एक के अंदर ये possibility है, we all can turn our lives. This is the beauty that human beings have got, कि 32,000 years तपस्या करने के बाद विश्वामित्र अपने जीवन को बिगाड़ने के लिए स्वतंत्र है, और 108 खून करने के बाद अंगुली माल अपने जीवन को बदलने के लिए स्वतंत्र है. दिस इज द ब्यूटी दैट वी हैव गॉट, कि वी कैन टर्न आवर लाइफ एट एनी मोमेंट वेन एवर वी वुड विश टू, एंड दैट इज द पॉइंट ऑफ हैविंग द एक्सलेंस इन द लाइफ. और यही गुरुदेव ने कहा कि जब हर एक व्यक्ति अपने जीवन की संभावना को अपने जीवन में उतार लेता है तो देवत्व ही निकल करके आ जाता है. कि इफ एवरीवन, हम में से हर एक के अंदर जो डिवाइन पोटेंशियल है, हम में से हर कोई अपने जीवन का डिवाइन पोटेंशियल रियलिटी में कन्वर्ट कर ले, तो वी डू नॉट हैव टू लुक फॉर एनी अदर हेवन, द हेवन वुड डिसेंड हियर. यदि 150 लोग जो यहाँ पर हैं, हर एक के अंदर का देवता जागता है, हर एक के अंदर की डिवाइन पोटेंशियल जाग जाए, तो वेदर वी वुड हैव टू गो फॉर एनी अदर प्लैनेट, वी डोंट हैव टू गो टू एनी अदर प्लैनेट, इट वुड टर्न राइट हियर. However, this is what actually the enlightened souls have said about the human potential, the excellence in the human lives. But हम लोग जब अपने चारों तरफ की दुनिया को देखते हैं, तो then we find many challenges. We do not find the excellence that Vivekananda is talking about, or Aurobindo is talking about, or Gurudev is talking about. We find a life that is full of many challenges. And I have selectively taken some of the challenges that are faced by the humanity. And just I'm going to start with the environment first. You know, this is the thing, that if Earth is 4.6 billion years old, this is what the scientists say, कि let's scale that to 46 years. यदि हम लोग उसको एक scale पर लेकर के आएं 46 years के, that means that we as human beings have been here for 4 hours, and our industrial revolution started a minute ago, करीब 200 साल पहले, and in that time alone, you know, 1 minute was given to the human beings to show to the universe that what can we do different, that you are giving the leadership of the whole universe, that what can we do different to make this universe a better place. And in that time duration alone, in 1 minute alone, we have destroyed 50% of world's forest. That's what we have done. कि जहाँ तक environment की बात आती है, कि जो 46 years में यदि आप पूरे के पूरे existence को, पूरे के पूरे genesis को समेट लें, और उसमें ह्यूमैनिटी को इस प्लेनेट पर आए हुए सिर्फ 4 घंटे हुए हैं, उन 4 घंटे में भी 1 मिनट ह्यूमन बींग्स को ये दिखाने के लिए मिला था कि हम लोग किस तरीके से दुनिया को बेहतर तरीके से जी सकते हैं. इन दैट टाइम ड्यूरेशन वी हैव डिस्ट्रॉयड 50% ऑफ वर्ल्ड्स फॉरेस्ट. एंड इंटरेस्टिंगली कि आज की तारीख में यदि आप लोग ये सोचें कि हर एक को, आई डोंट नो व्हाट इज द सिचुएशन हियर, पर यदि आप लोग कभी लंदन जाएं, बाहर जाएं, कहीं पर भी, तो पहला क्वेश्चन बिफोर हाउ आर यू इज दैट व्हाट इज द वाईफाई कोड. कि आप घर के अंदर घुसेंगे तो सबसे पहले आदमी पूछेगा कि वाईफाई का कोड क्या है, आदमी वहां पे जाना चाहता है. आज की तारीख में यदि हम लोगों को ये बोलने लग जाएं कि पेड़ों से वाईफाई के सिग्नल मिलते हैं, तो आई थिंक पीपल वुड डू मोर ट्री प्लांटेशन देन इफ यू टेल पीपल दैट इट गिव्स अस द ऑक्सीजन. क्योंकि क्या है कि ऑक्सीजन तो बहुत जरूरी चीज नहीं है इतनी वाईफाई है. तो आज की तारीख में क्या है कि लोगों के लिए वाईफाई इतना ज्यादा इंपॉर्टेंट हो गया है कि दैट हैज बिकम मोर सिग्निफिकेंट देन हैविंग द ऑक्सीजन फॉर पीपल टू ब्रीद. एंड देन दिस ऑल हैपेंड इन द नेम ऑफ द प्रोग्रेस. तो जब हम लोग प्रोग्रेस की बात करते हैं, यदि हम लोग यही देखना चाहें कि प्रोग्रेस के नाम पर हम लोगों ने क्या किया, तो आज से 15 साल पहले, 20 साल पहले एटलीस्ट लोगों की सोशल लाइफ हुआ करती थी, चाहे आपको मूवी जाना है या कुछ और ही करना है. Now everything has came down to only one piece of equipment, whether that's the phone or iPad or whatever, the tablet. Now I really like this statement. I don't know whether the people at the back can read it. It's from the Lothar Matthäus, one of the famous philosophers, and he said, "People were created to be loved." जो लोग थे, वो इसलिए बनाए गए थे कि हम एक दूसरे को प्यार कर सकें. जो संबंध हैं, जो relationship हैं, they were there so that people can love each other. Things were created to be used. ये चीज है, फोन है, all these things they were there to be used. And the reason world is in chaos because things are being loved and people are being used. कि आज की तारीख में जो chaos है वो इसलिए कि यदि आप लोगों से पूछें कि उनके लिए सबसे ज़्यादा प्यार भरी चीज़ क्या है तो हो सकता है कि लोगों के दृष्टि में उनका फ़ोन निकल करके आए या कार निकल करके आए या वो ऑब्जेक्ट्स निकल करके आए. आप किसी से भी पूछें तो लोग जो है दो घंटे बैठ करके अपना फेसबुक पर स्टेटस अपडेट करने को तो तैयार हैं पर घर में माँ बाप हैं पत्नी बच्चे हैं उनसे बात करने के लिए आदमी के पास समय नहीं है. कि थिंग्स जो जिन चीज़ों को हम लोग ने यूज़ करने के लिए बनाया था उनसे तो हम लोग प्यार करने लग गए हैं और जिन चीज़ों को हमने प्यार करने के लिए बनाया था संबंधों को उनको हम लोग यूज़ करने लग गए हैं. सो दैट इज़ वाई देर इज़ द होल यू नो शिफ्ट द पैराडाइम शिफ्ट बट इन ए रॉन्ग मैनर. एंड देन द एजुकेशन सिस्टम दैट वी हैव क्रिएटेड एंड आई विल कोट द वर्ड्स ऑफ अल्बर्ट आइंस्टाइन दैट एवरीवन इज़ अ जीनियस बट इफ़ यू जज a fish by its ability to climb a tree, it will live its whole life believing that it is stupid. हम लोगों ने यदि यही सिस्टम बना दिया कि हर एक को इसी क्राइटेरिया को पास करके दिखाना है तब हम जानेंगे कि आपकी वर्थ कितनी है सोसाइटी में. और यदि हर एक को ये बता दिया जाए कि आपको पेड़ पर चढ़ के दिखाना है तभी हम मानेंगे कि आपका जीवन जो है सफल है तो मछली तो जिंदगी भर यही सोचती रह जाएगी कि मैं तो मूर्ख हूँ बेकार में पैदा हो गई. यही जो हम लोगों ने क्राइटेरिया तय कर दिया है कि हर एक के सफलता का यही पैमाना है जब तक अनलेस यू पास दीज इंडिकेटर्स देयर इज नो पॉइंट ऑफ यू हैविंग इन द सोसाइटी द होल एजुकेशन सिस्टम हैज बिकम करप्टेड एंड दिस इज द लाइफ ऑफ द पीपल दैट वी हैव क्रिएटेड टेकन फ्रॉम बांसकी ग्राफिटी फेमस. वी बाय थिंग्स वी डोंट नीड विद मनी वी डोंट हैव टू इम्प्रेस पीपल वी डोंट इवन लाइक. कि लोग जो है दिल्ली से आप पूछें तो ओवरनाइट ट्रैवल करके दुबई जा रहे हैं शॉपिंग करने के लिए और आज की तारीख में ऐसा कुछ नहीं है जो दिल्ली में अवेलेबल नहीं है पर लोग जा रहे हैं और उस पैसे से खरीद रहे हैं जो संभवतः उनके पास है भी नहीं. उन लोगों को दिखाने के लिए खरीद रहे हैं जिनको शायद वो पसंद भी नहीं करते. आप US में चले जाइए लोग ऐसी ऐसी चीज़ें इकट्ठे करके बैठे हुए हैं जो गैराज सेल में निकल करके आएगी तो खुद ही सरप्राइज हो जाते हैं कि हमने कभी खरीदी भी थी. पर क्या है कि आदमी जो है चीज़ों को इकट्ठा करता जा रहा है जस्ट टू लिव ए लाइफ दैट वी डोंट नो वेयर इट्स गोना है. So we have seen that the purpose of having a pinnacle to the possibility is the human excellence. However, when we look around us, we find a very different and challenging world. So what we really need? We need is actually what I saw on your leaflet on the vision for India, be and make. We really need to have the excellence in the lives of the human beings as well as the excellence in the society. And Gurudev talked about five stages for having the excellence in the human life and I'm going to talk about them one in one. Uddesh, to have purpose in the life, ki we should really have a direction to the life, in which direction we would like to go. Then to have commitment for it, utsah. Utsarg is the having this feeling of living selflessly for the society. And utthan, living a life of essence, and then we have the excellence in our life. And I'm going to start with the Uddesh. He said that Uddesh vihin vyakti us pendulum ki tarah hota hai jo ghumta to bahut hai par jata kahin nahi. That you look at the people, you know, many people are busy from morning till evening. You go to metro cities, you go to London, and you will probably see your closest friend or your neighbor maybe 3 months from now. That people are happily occupied, they are busy. सुबह 7 बजे से घर से निकल जाएंगे, रात के 10 बजे लौटेंगे. सैटरडे के दिन भी उनके पास हार्डली इतना टाइम होगा कि अपनी फैमिली के साथ गुजार सकें. और जीवन इसी तरीके से आदमी का चला जा रहा है. एंड बिफोर दे गो टू 3 मंथ्स देन दे रियलाइज कि कहाँ हम लोग लास्ट टाइम कब अपने घर के साथ आराम के साथ बैठे थे. तो क्वेश्चन रियली इज कि वेदर वी आर ओनली ऑक्यूपाइड, क्या हम अपने आप को सिर्फ बिजी रख रहे हैं, और वेदर वी आर गोइंग विद द डायरेक्शन, क्या हम लोग किसी डायरेक्शन की तरफ बढ़ रहे हैं. मैं आपको बताऊँ कि जब मैं फर्स्ट डे था 2003 में चैरिंग क्रॉस हॉस्पिटल में जॉब लगी थी. हम लोग अभी अभी निकले हैमरस्मिथ हॉस्पिटल, हैमरस्मिथ ट्यूब स्टेशन से चैरिंग क्रॉस हॉस्पिटल इज अबाउट 12 मिनट्स वॉक. आप बाहर निकलो 12 मिनट की वॉक है. फर्स्ट डे थी जॉब में, कोई काम भी नहीं था विशेष. हम लोग निकले ट्यूब स्टेशन से, मैं और मेरा फ्रेंड थे. जैसे ही बाहर निकले मेरे दोस्त ने दौड़ना शुरू कर दिया. मैंने सोचा शायद जेब कट गई उसकी, मैं भागा उसके पीछे. मैंने कहा पता नहीं क्या हुआ. जब तक उसको पकड़ता और हम लोग वहाँ पे पहुँचते अपना ऑयस्टर जहाँ पर लगाते हैं टिकट चेक करने के लिए, मैंने पूछा क्या हुआ, तो बोला सब भाग रहे थे इसलिए भागने लग गया. तो दिस इज द थिंग दैट यू नो पीपल आर लिविंग द लाइफ दैट बिफोर वी रियलाइज वी जस्ट एक्चुअली फाइंड आउट दैट वी आर कॉपिंग समवन एल्स. कि हम लोग करे जा रहे हैं इस काम को क्योंकि हर कोई इस काम को कर रहा है. सो द क्वेश्चन वी शुड रियली आस्क when it comes down to the uddesh, when it comes down to the purpose, it's not about kya. Hum jindagi mein kya karte hain important nahi hai. Kyun karte hain important hai. Fansi par Bhagat Singh bhi chadte hai aur fansi par ek hatyara bhi chadta hai. Karan badal jata hai. Ki hum log kis kaam ko kis cheez ke liye kar rahe hain, kya outcome nikal ke aaya, that is not important. Par hum kyun kar rahe hain, what was our reason to do it, is always important. And that is the purpose of having the uddesh. And that is why I have taken some real life examples for you guys. Ki jab baat purpose ki aati hai to people think ki hum log bahut education le lenge to hum purpose lenge, hum log bade ho jayenge to purpose lenge, hum pe paisa hoga to purpose lenge. But sometimes all these things are not important. And that's why I have selected those people who actually defy that notion. Ki hum logon ko jab baat purpose ki aati hai, so these are the real life examples of those people who are there among us and live their life with purpose, with very simple things. And I would really appreciate if one of you guys can identify one of them, because ye hamare beech mein se nikle hue log hain aur zyada purani story bhi inki bhi nahi hai. Mere khayal se within 1 year ki story hogi.
Give me an opportunity to drink water.
आप में से कोई पहचान सकता है इनको? Excellent. Very, very good. I'm really impressed. Very good. Very good. Very good. Thank you very much, Buddha. Excellent. The person on the left hand side, she rightly pointed out, he received, his name is James Harrison, and he received the highest order of merit for any civilian to be received by any Australian about 2 years ago. So it happens very rarely. Jaise hum log kya Bharat Ratna aap har saal nahi dete. कभी कभी स्किप होता है और आप बहुत जो सेलेक्टेड जो टॉप मोस्ट सिविलियन ऑर्डर दिया जा सकता है ऑस्ट्रेलिया का, दैट वाज गिवन टू हिम एंड ही इज अ लेबरर, ही वर्क्स एज अ मैनुअल लेबरर. व्हाई इट वाज गिवन टू हिम, बिकॉज व्हेन ही वाज 14 इयर्स ओल्ड ही हैड अ मैसिव रोड ट्रैफिक एक्सीडेंट. बहुत तेज एक्सीडेंट हुआ, ही ऑलमोस्ट डाइड, ही नीडेड 13 लीटर्स ऑफ ब्लड टू बी सेव्ड, ही वाज इन कोमा फॉर 4 डेज, इट टुक हिम 3 मंथ्स टू कम आउट ऑफ द हॉस्पिटल. और जिन 13 लोगों ने उसको खून दिया जिसके कारण उसका जीवन बचा, फर्स्ट थिंग जेम्स हैरिसन डिसाइडेड कि आई कैन नॉट डू मच, मैं ज़्यादा पढ़ा लिखा नहीं हूँ, ज़्यादा कुछ काम नहीं कर सकता. ओनली थिंग आई वुड डू दैट द डे आई वुड टर्न 18, विच इज द लीगल लिमिट टू डोनेट ब्लड, आई वुड डोनेट ब्लड. सो ही वेंट टू द हॉस्पिटल ऑन हिज बर्थडे ऑन 18, वेंट टू द हॉस्पिटल. हॉस्पिटल दे डिड द टेस्ट, इफ यू एवर डोनेटेड योर ब्लड दे वुड डू द ब्लड टेस्ट फर्स्ट, and they found out that he had a specific type of antigen that can combat rhesus incompatibility disease. You know, जब माता पिता का ब्लड ग्रुप अलग अलग होता है बच्चे में चैलेंज आ जाता है, and in that condition you need a specific type of blood transfusion, and he had that combination. So that person donated 1000 liters of blood from the age of 18 to up to 77, which he is now, 1000 liters of blood, saving lives of 2 million unborn babies. 2 million unborn babies. His blood was transferred to 35 different countries. Simple objective, simple purpose of the life. हम लोग ये सोचते हैं कि हम लोगों को कोई बहुत चीज बड़ी करने की आवश्यकता है. We need a big institution. We need to have big setup. We need to have huge policy. Simple thing. कि मैंने blood donation का सोचा, and that's what he decided. That's what I am going to do. Simple objective, and he saved lives of 2 million unborn babies. James Harrison. And the guy, and the boy, in fact, not the guy, boy on the right hand side, his name is Kyle from Chicago. Last year, he won a lottery in a competition. मैंने पहले पूछ लिया पर मेरे ख्याल से अब पूछ नहीं पाया कि आप में से कोई जानता था क्या उन्हें. So he is 8 years old. Last year he won $1,000. And if you know 8 year old in US, he would won $1,000. What he would do? Probably go to Disneyland, you know, buy a pair of Jordans. For what he decided, that the girl living on the next door, Kyra, she had leukemia, she had blood cancer. So he phoned immediately to her mother and asked her that how much chemo could be bought with $1,000. And she started to cry. She said, 8 साल का बच्चा है, पूछ रहा है कि आप, बोले आपको पैसे की थोड़ी सी कमी थी, मेरे पास $1,000 है, I want to give you $1,000 so that Kaira can have the chemotherapy. They said that we cannot take from the 8-year-old boy. 8 साल के बच्चे थोड़ी पैसा ले सकते हैं. Parents started to cry. And then, but when people heard कि there is a boy like this who wanted to give his $1,000, all the people in the community, they came together. They came together to save that girl. And not only that girl, they managed to save 200 other girls with a similar condition. So that is the purpose in my opinion. 8 साल का बच्चा है, उसको भी पता है कि मैं सोसाइटी के लिए क्या अच्छा कर सकता हूँ. 77 ईयर का इंसान है, पढ़ा लिखा नहीं है, मजदूरी करता है, ईंट गारा उठाता है. He knows what to do with the life. And that to me is the purpose. And I think next lady, I think everyone in this room should be able to remember. She is from India. Anyone from West Bengal? Do you recognize her? I think she also came in one of the episodes of Satyamev Jayate. So maybe, you know, that would give enough hint for people to remember. Her name is Subhashini Mistri. Subhashini Mistri lives in a very small village called Hasan Pukur. And she is now 75, I think. When she was 21, you know, her husband had malaria, falciparum malaria. And she lives in a very small village. By the time they went to the hospital, so usko Calcutta le gaye. Calcutta mein jab tak hospital mein medical treat karte, husband died. And imagine that, you know, this woman who is 21, she became widow at the age of 21. She had 4 mouths to feed, 4 bachche the unke. Youngest one was 3 months old. She was illiterate, could not read or write her name, kuch nahi kar sakti thi. Aur she was a vegetable vendor. Sabji bech karke apna guzara karti. Hardly whatever, kitna earn kar sakte honge. Nowadays also you cannot earn much. Those days it was impossible to earn anything. But she decided at the age of 21 that I would open a hospital in my village. कि जितना भी पैसा मिलेगा, whatever I could save, I will try to save it to open a hospital in my village. And that's what Subhashini Mistri did. कि उनके 4 बच्चे थे, घर के लिए उन्हें एक चीज नहीं खरीदी, ना अपने लिए साड़ी खरीदी, ना बच्चों के लिए कपड़े खरीदे, ना घर के लिए एक अपने घर का कुछ बनवाया, ना घर में बर्तन भाड़ना खरीदा, कुछ नहीं. She did not purchase anything. For 47 years, whatever she could earn, either by selling vegetables or washing people's clothes or whatever, she saved it to open a hospital in the village. And that went on for 47 years. So, unka teesre number ka ladka Ajay, he became a doctor. He became MD from Calcutta. And uske baad, then, moment he was offered a job, he went back to serve in the village. And when aaspaas ke logon ne suna, jo uske professors the, colleagues the, peers the, when they heard ki kya hua, so they went to see in the village. And when wo log gaye, to they started to cry. Unne kaha, sir, aisi bhi koi mahila ho sakti, I cannot imagine. कि महिला जो पढ़ी लिखी नहीं है, सब्जी बेचकर भी गुजारा करती है, उसने इतने सालों में 47 इयर्स में शी डिड नॉट डू एनीथिंग फॉर हरसेल्फ. 20,000 रुपए शी मैनेज टू सेव. आप इमेजिन कर सकते हैं 20,000 रुपीज में एक महीने का रेंट भी नहीं आएगा. और वो 20,000 रुपीज शी मैनेज टू सेव. बट व्हेन पीपल हर्ड कि देयर इज अ वुमन लाइक दैट, पीपल स्टार्टेड टू गिव. किसी ने अपना घर दिया, किसी ने कुछ दिया, किसी ने कहा साहब हमारे घर में हॉस्पिटल खोल लो, हम पैसा नहीं लेंगे. जितने डॉक्टर थे कलकत्ता मेडिकल कॉलेज के, उन्होंने कहा साहब हम फ्री में यहाँ पे चिकित्सा करेंगे, वी विल कम फ्री एंड वी विल सी द पेशेंट्स फॉर फ्री. विद इन 2 इयर्स टाइम शी गॉट एनफ मनी टू ओपन ए हॉस्पिटल इन हर विलेज इन हसन पुकुर. एंड शी ओपनड ए हॉस्पिटल कॉल्ड ह्यूमैनिटी हॉस्पिटल, फ्रॉम पुअर फॉर पुअर, फ्री ले. आप वहाँ पे फ्री ट्रीटमेंट कराइए. 50 बेड का हॉस्पिटल खोला एक ऐसी महिला ने जो कि वेजिटेबल वेंडर है. शी इज वेजिटेबल वेंडर. आप सोच सकते हैं कि न तो जीवन में उद्देश्य होने के लिए बहुत एजुकेशन की आवश्यकता है, अंदर से डिटर्मिनेशन की आवश्यकता है. यदि हम लोग ये तय कर लें, एक ऐसा आदमी जो बहुत पढ़ा लिखा नहीं था, ब्लड डोनेशन की सोच लेता है, एक ऐसा लड़का जिसने तो अभी स्कूल देखा भी नहीं, वो ये तय कर लेता है कि मैं अपने $1,000 ल्यूकीमिया की पेशेंट को दे दूंगा. एक ऐसी महिला जो भारत के गरीब से गरीब एरिया से निकल करके आई है और वो ये तय कर लेती है कि मुझे अपने गांव में हॉस्पिटल खोलना है. 47 इयर्स तक, यू कैन इमेजिन 47 इयर्स. आप में से 2 लोगों की एज जोड़ लें तो 47 आएगी. इट इज सच ए, इट्स ए लॉन्ग अमाउंट ऑफ टाइम. इतने समय तक में आदमी की कॉन्शियसनेस कई बार शेक करेगी कि जिन लोगों के लिए मैं कर रही हूँ गाँव में, वो शायद जानते भी नहीं होंगे कि महिला मेरे लिए सेव कर रही. एंड इट जस्ट नीड्स ट्रू ग्रिट एंड डिटर्मिनेशन टू हैव क्वालिटी लाइफ. एंड दैट इज वॉट वी कॉल द एटीट्यूड. कि हमारे पास हर एक मॉर्निंग में we have got two choices. Either we can sleep with our dreams or we can wake up and chase them. That, you know, we continue with this determination in our life that we want to live a life of, perfection, then we can have that. Now, because you all are the policy makers, I have also got the examples of the people who are policy makers but also lived a life of good governance. I don't know whether you know any of them or you are able to see. The guy on the left hand side, I give a hint, he was the premier of one of the Latin American nations. Excellent, very good. Very good. He is the president of Uruguay, Jose Mujica. Very good. He is often actually called as the world's humblest president. The total wealth thi Jose Mujica ki by the time he retired was $1,800, and that was the cost of his Volkswagen Beetle, jisme ki wo rahe. Other than that, यदि आप कभी उनको गूगल करके देखो, उनका घर झोपड़ी की तरह से है. उसी झोपड़ी से उन्होंने अपनी सारी की सारी चीज़ें शुरू करी. He used to go in the public bus to the presidential palace. Presidential palace को पूरी तरह से छोड़ दिया होजे मुहिका ने. सामान्य व्यक्ति की तरह हॉस्पिटल में जाते थे, ट्रीट कराते थे एंड रिटायर्ड विद नथिंग इन हिज पॉकेट. जो उनकी $90,000 की आती थी, आउट ऑफ दिस 95% ही डोनेटेड एवरी सिंगल पेनी टू द पीपल. जो भी वहाँ के लोग हो सकते हैं उनको वापस उनने पूरी तरह से ही डोनेटेड इट बैक. Called also the most influential person. जब last year में कोलंबिया की situation हुई थी, crisis हुई थी, he was the person called. And उनका अपना aura इतना strong था कि in spite of the fact कि जब Jose Savage, जब उनकी death हुई और everyone was scared it would lead to a civil war situation in Colombia, his persona was so strong कि he managed to pacify everyone down. अपना जो नैतिक बल जिसको हम लोग बोलते हैं, it was so strong. And the guy on the right hand side, actually I'm forgetting the name, he was the president of Swiss Federation last year. And he used to do the same thing, apni koi wealth nahi rahi, he gave everything back to the society. It's a photograph of him taking the public train to go for his office term. Just in first day, he became the president, he took the public train to go directly like a normal man. So this is the these are the some examples that we all can have purpose regardless of the position that we take in the society. Now, second thing is the concept of the compassion. Once we have the right purpose in the life, once we have the right direction and right commitment for the life, then what we really need is the compassion. The question really should be asked that whether we are doing it for ourselves or we are doing it for the society. And I have got two simple examples for you, because to us, I think the purpose of human beings is the humanity. Unless we are doing a rightful, justful things for the humanity, there is no purpose of us being the human. If you have two human beings, so morphologically it is the same, psychologically there are variations. Psychologically people are different. If we go with the same strategy, that one human being is behaving like this, the other will do the same, so it is not possible. Because there is what actually differentiates one person to another is our integrity, is our value for the society, and the value for the society that we have is the humanity. These are two examples. One is a boy, now 2.5 years from Malaysia. He was born congenitally blind. पैदा हुआ तब से देख नहीं सकता था. He had a disease जिसके कारण he was unable to see. Both of his parents, mother and father, decided to donate one eye. कि हम लोगों को जितना देखना था हमको देख चुके, हमारे बच्चे को अच्छा फ्यूचर देखने को मिलना चाहिए. And that is a real life example. Where else you can find, you know, this act of compassion apart from human beings? कि parents को ये लगे कि हमारे को जितना जीना था हम लोग जी चुके, हमारे बच्चे को अच्छा future मिलना चाहिए. So they gave both one eye each. कि हम लोग एक आँख से जिंदा रह लेंगे, no problem. पर हमारे बच्चे को अच्छा future मिलना चाहिए. And second is from Bangalore, Padmanabh Temple. These two blind men, they were struggling, to get the water, पानी. नहीं आ पा रहा था, कोशिश कर रहे थे खोलने की. तो जो बंदर ऊपर देख रहा था पेड़ पे, वो नीचे उतर कर गया, he opened the tap so that blind people can have the water and returned back. Even जानवर के अंदर इतनी समझ है कि दूसरा आदमी कष्ट में है, पीड़ा में है, तो क्या करने की आवश्यकता है. Shame on those guys who were taking the photograph rather than trying to open the tap, you know. यदि फोटोग्राफ लेने की जगह पे वो ही टैप खोल देते तो शायद बंदर को ये कष्ट करने की आवश्यकता नहीं होती. बट दिस इज द एक्ट ऑफ कंपैशन. इवन एनिमल कैन थिंक ki what needs to be done if some other person is actually in trouble. And lastly, is the issue when it comes down to excellence is the commitment. Ki jab hum log ke paas right purpose hai, right attitude hai, compassion hai, ki hum society ke liye jee rahe hai, then the issue comes of the commitment. Ki jab sab kuch ho jane ke baad, the question really comes, is whenever it comes down to commitment, people already have the excuses. Ki unko to sab kuch diya tha, Bhagwan ne humko diya hota, to hum bhi karke dikhate. Ki hamare paas adhi cheez hoti, to hum bhi karke dikhate. So that's why I purposely taken the example, who were not born privileged like us, जिनके पास बहुत कुछ भगवान ने नहीं दिया और जो दिया था वो शायद छीन भी लिया, उसके बावजूद they did meaningful contribution to the society. So there are a couple of examples for you guys, and I think this person is well known all over the world. Anyone can say? Anyone? Huh? Ah, excellent, Terry Fox. Yeah, he is the guy actually very well known in Canada. And the guy actually, everyone knows Terry Fox? Then allow me to give a little introduction. Coincidentally, tomorrow is the 28th of June. You know, he died on 28th of June. The guy lived only up to the age of 21. When he was 19, he had osteosarcoma of the right leg. Unke daaye leg mein cancer ho gaya. He was given a prognosis to continue only for 6 months. Doctor ne bola ki zyada zyada 6 mahine jiyenge. Ab aap soch karke dekho ki 19-20 saal ka ladka jisko ye keh diya jaye ki aapki zindagi 6 mahine se zyada ki nahi hai, what you would do? People would sit at home, complain and struggle to cope. Many people develop depression. Terry Fox said, no, I want to make a meaningful contribution to those people who are like me. If you ever go to West, you would see a charity called Cancer Research. So jo cancer research ke liye paisa tha, first bout mein it came from Terry Fox. Terry Fox ko fund kiya tha Four Season Hotels ke owner ne, and it actually came. So he did something which is known as the Terry Fox Run. So with one leg, if you can see, the right leg was amputated. He's got artificial leg on the right hand side. With one leg, he started to run to collect money for those people, to charity for those people who were suffering from the cancer. And that person with one leg ran 143 days, 5,373 kilometers. 5,373 kilometers. It's just 2,000 kilometers short from the distance from here to London. You know, if you ever go, it's from top of the Canada to half of the US. It's that much of a distance. 143 din tak lagatar wo vyakti ek pair par daudta raha and covered a distance of 5,373 kilometers. That to me is an act of commitment. Ek hi pair Bhagwan ne diya, to hum log kya kar sakte hain? What else we can do different? For second one, I have got a clip to play.
My name is Jessica Cox and I live in Tucson, Arizona. I'm a motivational speaker. I've traveled to 17 different countries. My situation of being born without arms requires a lot of creativity. I would see all the kids around me climbing up the monkey bars or climbing up the slide, and for me I felt somewhat frustrated because I was prevented from that. I wouldn't have run up and climbed up that slide just like all the other kids. Sometimes I envision flying over the playground and being superwoman. I realized that I needed to adapt to the way everyone else did things. And it wasn't about catering to my needs or my special situation, but it was more about me adapting and being creative and coming up with ways of using my feet or using other methods to become independent. Put my pants onto the hook, then I just step into the pants like this, and I wiggle my way into my pants. I've heard the saying a number of times that, you know, life is 10% what happens to you, 90% of how you respond to it. So that's why I fell in love with psychology. Psychology fascinated me in that sense that it really did credit a lot to how we thought. It was a 3-year process to become a pilot. I had to find a specific airplane, and it has 2 less controls than most standard airplanes. And so therefore I can actually keep my right foot on the yoke, my left foot on the throttle. The most incredible, most empowering experience I've ever had. It's that feeling of being free, of being, you know, in the sky, and just that incredible feeling of being up there. What I enjoy is not really knowing where I'm going to be next. In the next 4 months, I'm going to be in 4 different countries.
And I remember promising myself I would never again wear those fake, heavy, prosthetic arms.
Excuse our flight. We will go out to the different areas of Ethiopia, visit with the families of children with disabilities, and help them overcome their own difference as well, and bring that confidence that I had to develop over the years, and help share that with them. The achievement that I'm most proud of, I think, is maturing from someone who was angry and upset about being differently abled, or being someone who was different, and to now being able to celebrate that and use it as an opportunity to give hope and inspiration to other people.
The reason to share that presentation with you is, I think, pretty obvious, that when it comes down to commitment, and whenever we all have got ups and downs in the life, and whenever down of our life would come, I think we can remember these guys. The guy that was born without a leg, you know, or was with a leg but had to sacrifice one of the legs. And the girl, Jessica, you know, she's only 21, as a honors psychology student from Harvard. She's the first armless pilot of the world, black belt in karate, and she's only 21, and she had got no arms. So imagine, you know, the people we are definitely born more privileged than these guys, and we can do something definitely good, meaningful, and positive to this world. So that was the idea to share this presentation. And the last one, very last, is the Uthan. That, you know, Gurudev said that Dhwan Saral hai. Destruction is very easy. That when we have got all these things, when we have got purpose of the life, when we have got the right attitude for it, when we have got the right commitment for it, what we really need to remember, that whether we are living for the constructive purposes or whether we are using this thing for the wrong. People, you know, they can use it for both sides. Destruction is easy. Destruction karne ke liye to choti si chingari aur sadi keel bhi kar sakte hai. But jo real value hai, wo positive kaamon ko karne mein. Yadi aap sadak par ja rahe ho, koi bhi vyakti ja raha ho, aur usko koi aadmi aakar ke step kar de, he does not need a qualification, he does not need a certification. To hurt other people, to do damage, you do not really need a university qualification. But if that person received a wound, for that to be repaired, you need to be a qualified doctor. You know, you cannot do just by on the road. आपको चीज को बनाना है तो बनाने के लिए आपको बहुत सारी मेहनत की और प्रयत्न की आवश्यकता है. बिगाड़ने के लिए तो बहुत आसानी से उस काम को किया जा सकता है. So what we really need to remember, that whether our energy, whether our abilities, whether our competence are being used for the just purposes, whether they are being used to give nation, ourselves, country a rightful direction. And when all that comes, then we have got the excellence in the life, whether it is in the life of Vivekananda or in the Gurudev, that is the purpose, that they all live their lives with this sort of concept in the mind, to have the right mindset, right attitude, right purpose, right direction, and the right competence. And I will go to the very last of it, because I am aware that we would have to travel back. And so only thing, very last, that I would like to share with you, that Einstein said that, you know, this world is a dangerous place to live, not only because of those people who are wrong. केवल उनकी वजह से दुनिया बुरी नहीं है जो लोग बुरा करते हैं, बल्कि उनकी वजह से भी है जो लोग अच्छे हैं पर ये सब कुछ देखते हुए चुप बैठे रहते हैं. So I think the question really we should ask that, you know, many things are happening around us which are not right. But whether we are doing enough to change it is the question that we should ask. The question we should really ask that whether we are united together. You know, आज की तारीख में जो problem है वो ये है कि जिन लोगों के पास abilities हैं, they do not have the right intention. और जिनके पास right intention है, उनके पास power authority नहीं है. So when people like you who would reach to the power and authority, you should also have the good intention to do something good, meaningful, positive and right with the society. And that is what I would wish you to remember. And very lastly, you know, the whenever it comes down to the question of changing the world or changing the whole nation or changing the society, people say that, you know, why us? Ask other people to change and then we will also change. And that is why I purposely brought this example. कि जब भी ऐसा आता है तो लोग कहते हैं कि भाई उनको समझा दो फिर मैं भी करने को तैयार हो जाऊँ. And that is why this example is there. It's the example of Horatius. Horatius was the captain of the gate of fort of Rome. जब क्लूशियम की सेना ने हमला किया, he was the सेनापति. He was the general of the army. Everyone left. There were 300 soldiers of the army of the Rome and everyone left because क्लूशियम has 3,000 people. Only Horatius was standing there with two of his soldiers. दो लोगों को लेकर के वहाँ पे खड़ा हुआ था and both of his assistants died. वो लोग भी मर गए. मरने से पहले उसके असिस्टेंट ने पूछा, why are we here? हम लोगों को भी छोड़ जाना चाहिए था. सब तो भाग गए, हम भी भाग जाते तो क्या हो जाता. And what Horatius said is worth remembering. He said, then out spoke brave Horatius, the captain of the gate. To every man upon this earth, death comes soon or late. And how can man die better than facing fearful odds? For the ashes of his fathers and the temples of his gods. So I think that is the point that we all should remember. That यदि हम लोग इस देश को अच्छा बनाने के लिए शहीद भी हो जाए, और शहीद होने का मतलब हमारे शरीर का जाना नहीं होता, हमारे वैल्यूज़ की सेक्रीफाइस भी होती है, सही जगह पे हमारी भावनाओं को लगना भी होता है, सही डायरेक्शन पे हम सबका मिलना भी होता है. यदि हम लोग वो करते हैं तो फिर हम लोगों का इस धरती पर आना और कुछ अच्छा कर पाना इन रियल सेंस इट वुड बी ए मीनिंगफुल जर्नी फॉर ऑल ऑफ अस. That is what I wanted to convey. I hope you know I was able to convey to you. So that's it. And in the very last, we have got a national anthem for you, sung by those kids actually who are unable to speak. So I would urge everyone for the national anthem to stand up. Thank you. Very good questions, actually, they have come. One question is, how do we define right? First of all, I think the way that that's the conflict between ethics and the spirituality. That's why actually never ethics has never been able to reach to a definition of the right. Because the right and wrong hai, they change as per the society. What is right for one person may not be right for another person. Aap hum log Hindu dharm mein sochte hain ki jaise aadmi rahe doodh piye aur sari cheeze acche se rahe, it is a very good thing. You go to a society in Quakers in France and people would find that is the worst thing that you are doing. कि आपने बछड़े के मुंह से उसका खाना ले लिया, इससे ज्यादा वर्स्ट और कुछ हो ही नहीं सकता. जो राइट और रॉन्ग की डेफिनेशन है, दे चेंज एज पर द सोसाइटी. आई थिंक वेयर पर्सन शुड लुक फॉर द राइटनेस इज नॉट इन द सोसाइटी बट इनसाइड अस. जो चीज सही और गलत होती है उसका उत्तर यहां पर जो भी ऊपर वाला है उसने हमारी अंतरात्मा में बिठा दिया है. इफ यू डू द रॉन्ग थिंग, ट्रस्ट मी, इफ यू आर रियली लिसन टू आवर अंतरात्मा, if we are doing the wrong thing, जो guilt है, it would tell us immediately. लोग फोटो खींच रहे होंगे, पर यदि आपकी अंतरात्मा को लगेगा कि आपने गलत काम किया है, you would not be able to sleep that night. यदि हमारे अंदर से कोई गलत काम हो गया है, you would never be able to sleep that night. यदि हम लोग कोई अच्छा काम करेंगे, the satisfaction and the contentment that we did the right thing would tell us immediately. यदि कोई चीज है और आपको सारी दुनिया गाली भी दे रही हो, पर यदि आपने लगाया कि आपने सही काम किया, you would care less about the society. तो जो चीज़ है राइट और रॉन्ग की डेफिनेशन, आई थिंक इज द कॉल ऑफ द सोल. कि यदि हम लोग अपने मन को सही तरीके से समझने की कोशिश करते हैं, आई थिंक एवरी वन हियर्स. आई वर्क एज अ साइकेट्रिस्ट एंड आई वर्क विद द पेशेंट्स एक्चुअली हु वर फार वर्स, एंड एवरी वन थॉट दैट दे हैव द कैलस एटीट्यूड, और उनको कोई सोसाइटी के नॉर्म्स की चिंता नहीं थी. एंड एट वन टाइम वी वर कवरिंग द हॉस्पिटल ब्रॉडमूर, विच इज़ वन ऑफ द हाइएस्ट सिक्योरिटी यू नो साइकेट्रिक प्रिजन ऑफ द होल इंग्लैंड, और जो सीरियल किलर्स हैं सब वहाँ पर होते हैं. वी हैव सीन सीरियल किलर्स क्राइंग लाइक बेबी, कि आपने उनको उनके अंदर जो गिल्ट है कि वॉट एवर दे हैव डन, ओनली थिंग इज दैट देयर वे टू कोप विद द गिल्ट इज क्रिएटिंग अनदर मर्डर. एक मर्डर किया और उसके बाद आपको इतनी गिल्ट हुई कि आप दूसरी चीज को करने के लिए फिर दोबारा करते हो. गिल्ट रिमेन्स द सेम, बट इफ यू आर एबल टू लिसन टू योर हार्ट एंड इफ यू आर एबल टू लिसन कि हमारे अंदर से क्या चीज हुई, उसको आप करना चाहते हो, यू इमीडिएटली गेट द आंसर टू व्हाट इज राइट. आंसर टू राइट इज इनसाइड अस. A very good question. There are many good points in our culture, but why our people in our country avoid it in the name of religion when the other countries are embracing and learning our culture with ease? Example, the recent Yoga Day political issue. I think it's a very good question. I think that is a question of Atma Samman. कि हम लोग अपनी culture को, अपने भारत को, अपनी society को कितने self-respect के साथ देखना चाहते हैं. You know, people are coming from other countries to us and they try to get whatever is the good we are able to offer, whether it's in the in our wisdom, whether it's in our knowledge, in our values. Aur hum log dusre desh se kya lekar ke aate hain? Hip hop lekar ke aate hain, burger lekar ke aate hain, pizza lekar ke aate hain. There is something wrong in the attitude that we are trying to pursue. Ki hum log dusri jagahon se wo cheez lekar ke kyon nahi aa sakte, which is right. Hum log ye lekar ke kyon nahi aa sakte ki hame queue mein lagne ki avashyakta hai. हमें ये भी लेकर के क्यों नहीं आ सकते कि हमें मेहनत के साथ अपने काम को करने की आवश्यकता है. हम ये लेकर के क्यों नहीं आ सकते क्योंकि हमें पंक्चुअलिटी के साथ अपने काम को सही समय पर सही जगह पर उपस्थित होने की आवश्यकता है. दैट वी कैन नॉट ब्रिंग. एंड ऑलमोस्ट हाफ ऑफ द इंडिया ट्रेवल्स टू द एब्रॉड. ऐसा कोई व्यक्ति नहीं जो एब्रॉड नहीं जाता होगा, वहाँ जाते से ही रूल्स को सारे को फॉलो करने लग जाता है. एंड द सेम पीपल वुड रिटर्न हियर एंड दे वुड डू एब्सोल्युटली अपोजिट टू इट. तो हम लोग वहाँ से वो चीज़ों को लेकर के नहीं आना चाहते जो कि चीज़ें इस कंट्री की वैल्यू को बढ़ा सकती हैं, इस कंट्री की इंटीग्रिटी को बेहतर कर सकती हैं, पर दूसरे को हम देने को तैयार हैं, अपने आप को लेने को तैयार नहीं. तो आई थिंक दिस इज़ अ वेरी गुड पॉइंट एंड दिस इज़ अ क्वेश्चन ऑफ द सेल्फ रिस्पेक्ट एंड द आत्मसम्मान. कि हम लोग यदि अपनी ही संस्कृति को इस तरीके से देखेंगे कि वो बेकार की चीज़ है, तो दूसरे व्यक्ति को देखने में क्या जा रहा है. हम लोगों को अपने खुद आत्मसम्मान के साथ खड़े होने की आवश्यकता है, देन ओनली वी वुड बी एबल टू प्रोवाइड समथिंग गुड एंड वैल्यूएबल टू द सोसाइटी. इसकी शायद बैटरी थोड़ी सी लो हो रही है. एक और क्वेश्चन है, हाउ डू वी नो दैट इसकी बैटरी. The question is actually that just the question that has arrived is, what is the purpose? How do we know? I think we know our purpose later on. Like, you know, if you look at the examples that I have given, that the person who decided to give the blood for the society, वो इसने ये सोच करके नहीं दिया होगा कि मेरी लाइफ का पर्पस ये है कि मुझे ब्लड डोनेट करना है. उसने ये सोच करके दिया होगा कि दिस इज द राइट थिंग टू डू एंड आई शुड डू इट फॉर द सोसाइटी. तो हम लोगों के लिए एवरी मोमेंट इफ वी थिंक दैट व्हाट इज राइट थिंग टू डू, पर्पस इज डिफाइंड लेटर ऑन. पर्पस इज और फॉर एकेडमिक पर्पजेज, कि जब आपने किसी जीवन को जी लिया तो लोग कहेंगे कि आपके जीवन का पर्पस ये था. बट एट दैट मोमेंट व्हाट वी डू इज डिपेंडिंग अपॉन व्हाट वी थिंक इज द राइट. यदि हम लोग राइट चीज को करते हैं, then it turns into the right thing, then it becomes the right purpose.
Sir, I agree with everything that you have shared, except for one specific topic. And since there were only questions that are supposed to be asked on the WhatsApp group, this is more of a comment and a request. It's more of a comment and a request, because you also talk to a lot of people. I'm sure that all the inspiring stories that you shared with us and the examples that you gave, if you personally went and asked them, they would most probably tell you that they feel like normal human beings. Right? They would not think that they did anything extraordinary. So my only request is, if you could change the heading of the entire presentation from human excellence to a normal human, because I think that is just being normal, right? So even whether if you had asked probably Swami Vivekananda, I don't think he ever thought of divinity in any form or in any aspect. And I think it's our limitations which actually make us look at these things. Now, for example, you show, the presentation of the national anthem that came across. Now, people who are dumb, who can't hear, across the world are about 70 to 75 million, which is equivalent to, say, the entire speaking population of in Tamil or in Telugu, equal amounts, right? Or Kannada also. They all range between 70 to 78 million, which means to say that it is just a language that we don't understand. And just because I do not know sign language, it is my disability and not theirs. Right? So I believe everybody you showed was normal. And to aspire to being normal is not, you know, outside the boundary. If anything, we have to grow up to be normal. So that's my only request.
I absolutely agree. I think the purpose of the presentation the purpose of the presentation is not to glorify anyone and not to say that, you know, one person would have a different meaning than the another. I'm very sure, like you are right, that Swami Vivekananda would actually look at it differently and he would probably never want his name to go into the presentation. But idea is not that, you know, we should glorify them and think that, okay, Swami Vivekananda did this. Idea is, like I said in the beginning, that it's not the idea that this is how one should live. Idea is to provoke questions into our consciousness that whether we are doing justice to the life that's been offered to us. And I'm sure that many of you are probably doing the justice to your life. But those who are not, the presentation is meant for those people, that those who are not, maybe they can pause for a second and think that what else we can do different to our lives that can change the course of the humanity. That is the idea of the presentation. And in addition to that, you know, that the last national anthem is not there for any other reason apart from emotional reason, because that presentation is actually shared by a disabled friend. So wherever I go, I usually play that national anthem only because of my emotional connection to that friend, rather than anything else, rather than anyone else. That, you know, because they were unable, they are unable to sing it, they said it in the manner that could reach to our heart. So it is mainly for the emotional reason for myself. Thank you. Thanks to all of you.